having already ordered a probe into the circumstances wherein hundreds attended a marriage function in Patna, which left more than 100 infected with COVID-19. Patna District Magistrate Kumar Ravi has now instructed officials to hold a special camp to take swab samples of everyone who may have attended or are in any way connected to the June 15th wedding that created a chain of COVID-19 infections in Paliganj. The administration's focus is clearly to trace and test all the COVID-19 suspects linked to the wedding. The district magistrate has tasked the Paliganj subdivisional officer to conduct a probe into the lapses that allowed hundreds to attend the wedding while throwing social distancing norms to the dogs. Incidentally, the groom Anil Kumar, who was suffering from fever, died just after 2 days after the wedding, without getting tested for COVID-19. The Barat, groom's marriage procession, had started from Paliganj and gone to Piplava under Naubatpur block in rural Patna. Having already tested over 350 samples from Paliganj, the district administration has now also zeroed in on Piplava locality where the marriage was solemnized. The Barat had returned to Paliganj on June 16, but the groom, who was suffering from fever, died on June 17. His parents hurriedly cremated the body and did not get his COVID-19 test done. The groom, a software engineer in Gurugram, had reportedly refused to marry on the scheduled date because of his high fever, but he was persuaded by his parents, who also gave him some medication to control the temperature. Earlier, he had reached Patna from Gurugram on May 23. The groom's father, a school teacher at Paliganj, had invited many guests for the wedding ceremony. As the news of the groom's death created a panic, the district health authorities tested his close relatives on June 19, which confirmed 15 positive cases of COVID-19. As the health administration knew that many others had also attended, it held special camps at Paliganj from June 24 to June 26, collecting 364 swab samples. When these were tested, 86 of them turned out to be COVID-19 positive. The administration's negligence has been exposed at various levels, a senior officer said. For one, the marriage ceremony was allowed to take place with the number of guests clearly exceeding 50, which is the limit set for wedding functions. Earlier in May, when the Ministry of Home Affairs put a cap on 50 guests for attending wedding ceremonies, the message was loud and clear that social distancing was the key to ward off the COVID-19 threat. The Union Health Ministry has also maintained that large gatherings must be avoided as a social distancing measure, as it is possible that close family contacts may be symptomatic and/or shedding the virus.